Well, hello again. It's nice to see you back. I want to tell you another story, a continuation of the one I told you before. Thomas is a tank engine, with six small wheels, a short stumpy funnel, a short stumpy dome, and a short stumpy boiler. He's a fussy little engine too. He always pulls coaches about, ready for the big engines to take on different journeys. And when the trains are brought back to the station, he takes them into the empty siding so that the bigger engines can go and rest. However, sometimes his important role in other jobs can get to his head. He thinks nobody works as hard as he does. He loves playing tricks on the bigger engines, including Gordon, who is the biggest and proudest of them all. Thomas would often freak and whistle rudely at him. One morning, Gordon was resting in the siding. Thomas, who's still mad at Gordon for being rude to Edward, came up quietly behind Gordon and whistled loudly.
Hey! Hey, Gordon! Gordon!
What's happening?
Wake up, lazy bones! We have work to do, remember that? Why don't you try to work hard like me?
However, this time around, Gordon did not go back to sleep. Instead, he came up with a plan to get back at Thomas. The next morning, Thomas couldn't wake up. His driver and fireman couldn't make his fire start. It was nearly time for the express. Gordon waited patiently for Thomas's arrival, and at last, Thomas started.
I'm going to be late.
He got Gordon's coaches ready while Gordon eyed him.
Hurry up, you!
You know what? Why don't you just hurry yourself, Gordon, you big blue whale on wheels? You're too fat, and you need exercise, all right?
Oh, don't worry. I will.
Gordon hastily backed down on his coaches.
Get in quickly, please.
Thomas would usually push the train to get it started, but he was always uncoupled for this. But this time, Gordon set off too quickly. It was all Gordon's original plan. The train kept going faster and faster, much too fast for little Thomas.
Gordon! Stop!
Hurry, hurry, hurry!
Thomas was going faster than he ever had before. He was out of breath, but he had to go on. Alas, they stopped at the station. Marklin had just arrived at the train. He eyed the scene inside.
I'm not even surprised.
Thomas was uncoupled, and he ran onto the turntable, feeling embarrassed. He thought about everybody laughing at him. Gordon smirked, but then felt a little sorry for Thomas. He made his way back to the shed slowly, and made sure that they never teased Gordon again. He arrived back at the sheds, and didn't say a word to anyone. He slid back into his berth and shut his eyes. The right engine looked at Edward. They both felt sorry for Thomas. Meanwhile, on the other side of the shed, a big blue engine, named Henry, was getting cleaned. He was scheduled for a passenger train tomorrow, and as he looked out towards the night sky, he'd realized the sky had grown cloudy. It looked like it was going to rain tomorrow. Now, Henry has always had a dislike for the rain, but I mustn't say any more, or I shall spoil that sewing if I do.